Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our Jurassic World Evolution 2 Mod Spotlight Series. It's been a hot minute since we last did this, but I'm really excited to dig into some more mods. We've got seven, kind of more than that if you want to stretch it a little bit, but at least seven really cool, really top level mods to take a look at today. Ones I'm really excited to showcase. I hope you enjoy. Let me know in the comment section down below if you do. Throw me a like, all that kind of jazz. Bingo, bango, shingo, shango. Anyways. As per usual, very quick disclaimer, mods can possibly break your game if you're messing around with tons of them, especially when the game updates, that's a little bit of a problem. If mods do break your game, it's not my fault, it's not the mod maker's fault, and most importantly, it's not Frontier's fault, you big old numpty. All that said, let's get started, as Modius has joined us for the first time in a very long time.
Hello!
Still sounds exactly the same, he's been off on a Reiki course. And I don't know enough about Reiki to continue this joke. I know it's like a physical therapy, mind, soul therapy kind of thing. Anyways, that's about all I've got. So, let's dig into some mods, some really cool stuff. And we're going to kick things off with a new Velociraptor. What an absolute beauty. So these are the Dino Tracker Velociraptors. This is the male. I've got the female out already. I'll show you her in a second. These were made by Viral Cyclopes, Draco Warrior, Pokemon Fan 2750. And originally, the original design was made by Jaroslav Kosmina for the Dino Tracker. You remember the Dominion Dino Tracker? We covered it here on the Best in Slot channel. We took a look at that a lot. They were actually made for that, and they never made it into release, unfortunately. I'm going to bring up an image very quickly so you can see the concept art for these, and you'll get a feel for why these are so cool. The idea behind these raptors, behind this male and female, was that it's a kind of a cross between the version 1 raptors, like we see in Jurassic Park and The Lost World, and the raptors later on seen in Jurassic Park 3. So you can see with our male here, it's got the quills from the Jurassic Park 3 raptor, it's got that kind of striping effect, but it's got those warmer red-orange colours seen in the earlier raptors, in the tiger raptor and in Jurassic Park 1 raptor. It's a really interesting idea, taking those two sets of genetics and fusing them together to make these version 3 raptors. It's a big shame we never saw it, but it's really cool that we can now see it in our games. And I've got to say, it's a fantastic looking skin, isn't it? It looks really cool. And we can also take a look at the female. I prefer the male, that's why we led with that. That is also a male. Where are the ladies at? There is the ladies. So she, as you can see, has more of those paler colours. I mean, that is a beauty as well. No quills. Paler colours are seen in Jurassic Park 3, and actually has some of this sort of tiger striping effect down the side, as you would see in the Lost World Tiger Velociraptor. Either way, two beautiful raptor skins, just a nice little, not a deep cut, but a little slight slice into Jurassic Park lore there. Okay, because... yeah, there we go. This is a Minecraft pig, a mod by Mitchell Productions, and... I don't know, they're all going crazy right now. But the point is, Minecraft Pig, let me get him into the light as he bounds around. Minecraft Pig replaces your Minecraft goat, your normal goat, I should say, not your Minecraft goat, replaces your normal goat with a Minecraft pig. And it looks really, it's really well done. It's super effective. There's actually another mod as well that replaces it with a horse instead, made by the same person. And I think there are plans to also bring in the villager and stuff like that. I don't know. It's a bit of daft fun, but I think it's, Next on our list, then, we have a Giganotosaurus. And officially, maybe my favourite Giga in the game already. Some of you will, of course, recognise this instantly. Those of you who like your older Jurassic Park stuff, this is the Lost World Jurassic Park Giganotosaurus from 1997. There was a Lost World game on the PS1. I've got a full playthrough of it right here on the channel if you want to check it out. And although it actually never made it into the game, there's a much-known concept art for a Giga from that game. They never made it into the actual game, but we have the concept art for it, and it looks just like this. But not only is it a lovely skin for the Giga that represents it, but it's like a whole new model as well. It's really, I mean, a little bit funky on the neck there, but other than that, really, really nice Giga model. Really, like a nice blend between the Frontier version and the more over-the-top spiked version that we got in Jurassic World Dominion. Really, really attractive. And it even comes with extra non-concept art skins. If we hop just down here, you'll see we've got this one over here. This is the blueback skin. And it's really nice. This is like, it feels like a whole new dinosaur. And we now have three different Gigas in the game. More if you want to use, some people have released mods that make the Dominion Giga toned down a little bit, which is really cool with the new skins as well. I'm not going to showcase that today, but we'll take a look in the future. But yeah, shout out to, if I haven't already, it's the same three people, Viral Cyclops, Draco Warrior, Pokemon Fan 2750 for this really nice little piece of Jurassic Park history. I love these skins that pull from the franchise history, and I adore the Lost World game on the PS1, so this is a really nice choice for me. Love that. Right, next on our list, we're going to zoom through this one. Get out of the way, Raptors. You're all blocking the hatchery. This is Chilantisaurus. So this is Chilantisaurus. This is a late Cretaceous Chinese theropod. We're not going to talk too much about it. This is made by Master Doot. It has been showcased here on the channel before. I think in the last video or the video before, I've showcased this exact same dinosaur. But in the past, it was a replacement and it's now officially a new species. And that's really all I wanted to talk about. You can now download it and have it as an original species. It's got a really interesting design. I love the head shape and head details in particular. That long, boxy, but thin snout is really interesting as well. Really interesting dinosaur. Don't want to talk too much about it because we've already seen it, but yeah, just worth knowing that it's now a new species and will work with your post-Malta update. Right, next up we're going to check out a redo on the Dilophosaurus. So this is Pickles Paleo Overhaul Dilophosaurus. Look at it bounding through the air. And it just makes the Dilophosaurus a little bit more paleo accurate. So there's a couple of small changes on the feet and the hands have been fixed, you know, the wrist position and stuff like that has been fixed. But the main thing, of course, is the frill has gone because that's not paleo accurate. I love the frill, don't get me wrong, but if you were doing a more paleo accurate sort of park, which you can definitely do with some of these fantastic mods, then you would download this mod. And in order to keep the color and the design of the frill, what they've done instead is give the Dilophosaurus this double-barreled kind of crest above the head, and you can see that it's got that classic Jurassic Park styling still on the crest. So it still has all the design elements or the colors and the patterns of the Dilophosaurus we know and love, but it's applied to a more accurate Dilophosaurus. Now, speaking of paleo overhauls, we're going to check out another one here. This is going to be Liv's paleo overhaul. Now, Liv has released a bunch of these. We've checked them out in the past. We saw their pterosaurs in the past. They were really, really good. But this one is a miscellaneous pack, and we're going to check out two of them. First of all, Therizinosaurus. So, the idea, of course, is to make the dinosaurs in this pack more paleo accurate, which means in Therizinosaurus' case that it becomes freaking terrifying. But yeah, you can see some differences here. The feathers have been changed around. We've got these feathers splaying out on the elbow. The head shape is the major difference. It's much kind of duck-like, bird-like away as well, with the snout and the beak there. And the neck is longer and thinner, and the body's been brought in a little bit as well. It's a little bit less chunky down there. It looks bizarre, to say the least. The head in particular, it is the major change, and it is very, very weird stuff. I don't know what else to tell you. It looks freaky as anything. But you know what? Again, if you want your paleo overhaul, you want this long-necked giraffean giant bounding around your park, then, you know, this big old scrangly dinosaur, I should say, even though it's not a word. You want it bounding around your park, you have an option for that. Chilanti, you are so in the way. So in the way. So in the way. Right, we've got one more I want to showcase from Liv's miscellaneous pack. There are other creatures in this pack, it's worth noting. There's a Dryosaurus, for example, but I'm just going to showcase two of them. This is... Bless them. This is the Lystrosaurus. So again, the idea is just to make it a little bit more paleo accurate. The major change, as you can see, with the Lystro, of course, is the head shape. The skull, the crest, has been brought massively down. And I've got to say, it might even be cuter a little bit. Let's get it into away from the grass a little bit. But, I mean, it is super cute, bless its little cotton socks. It just looks a little smaller now. It's got an even smaller little head. It looks like a happy little puppy dog. That crest has been brought down. There's a couple other changes as well. If you go on the Paleo Hall overhaul page, which of course I'll link down below along with every other mod that I've showcased today, definitely go give the mod makers some love. I love those giggers, I really do. Liv does a really cool thing where they show a before and after of the artwork for the Dominion version or the whatever version and their Paleo overhaul version, so you can see exactly what's changing between each species, which I really like. I love when mod makers do that, and I wish every mod maker did that. I accept that it's hard work, but really showcases what the differences are. So yeah, a lot of Paleo overhaul stuff today, a lot of edits to existing dinosaurs. The Giga feels like a whole new species. The Dilo looks completely different. The Therese a monster. The Listro is adorable. Chilanti, really cool to have a new species. Love those new Raptor skins as well. One last thing to show you. Triclaw Gaming, who we've featured a few times on the channel, does a lot of path mods. They bring out new paths. And there's an Alpine one, and there's one based on Jurassic World Evolution 1 and JPOG. We've showcased a few of these in the past, but there's a new Malta one now with four different variations, which you can download. It's a shame we don't have more path options. It'd be really cool if we could have more choices and, you know, mix it up in that regard. I think Evo Squared in particular would die happy if that happened. But this is the Malta Pack 4. It was my favourite of the bunch. This is what I've chosen. So we've got a rusted metal square kind of effect. That's your sort of basic path. If we then go into our wide through Furathera path, our sort of non-posh path but our main walking path, we've got this kind of slightly sandstony light brick kind of texture, very Maltese. This perfect for a Malta park. We might even keep this installed for our Malta build we're doing on the sandbox. And then finally, for your luxury path, you've got this really nice, this is why I use this one in particular, you've got this really nice bright sort of slats of wood as well. So you can see how that feels a little bit more Maltese in terms of the coloration. Like I say, there are variants in this. There's three other variations of the Malta pack you can download. You can download the Alpine pack. You can download the Forest pack or whatever it is. So whatever park you're building in Sandbox, you can download the appropriate path mod and kind of bring everything together thematically a little bit better. Yeah, looks really good. Really effective. So yeah, some really cool mods today. I know we haven't done this series in a little while. I think things have died down a little bit modding-wise. I think, as per usual, people are a little tired of everything dying with every update. It's just, it is how it is, you know, until the game stops updating, it's just kind of part and parcel of this world. When the game does stop updating, we'll see what happens. But people are still bringing out some really fantastic stuff. Really, really love all seven mods today. I think they're all, yeah, top-notch stuff. Really excited about that. So definitely go give the mod makers some love. I'm going to link all of these mods in a Google Doc down below, so you can follow those links and check them out for yourself. And go give the mod makers some love. And if you've got some love to spare, you know, say you've got 78 loves and you give 54 of them to the mod makers and you've got 24 loves to spare because you've got no one else to love, give it to me. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Stick around on the channel for more Jurassic World Evolution 2 and lots more paleo media coverage in general. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.